ranch life for many years and knows it very well. Just where to stop, Thomas, laughed his driver. You can almost manage it without me. Thomas had become conceited. He didn't realize his driver was joking. Later, he boasted to the others. Driver says I don't need him now. Don't be so daft, snorted Percy. I'd never go without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be frightened. Boasted Thomas. I'm not scared. You never dare. I would then. You'll see. The next morning, the firelighter came. Thomas drowsed comfortably as the warm spread through his boiler. Percy and Toby were still asleep. Thomas suddenly remembered. Silly stick in the mud, he chuckled. I'll show them. Driver said I could manage without him. I'll just go out. Then I'll stop and whee-sh! That'll make them jump. Thomas thought he was being clever. Really, he was only moving because a careless cleaner had meddled with his control. He soon found his mistake. He tried to whee, but he couldn't. He tried to stop, but he couldn't. He just kept rolling along. He didn't dare look at what was coming next. There was the station master's house. The station master was about to have breakfast. Horrors! Cried Thomas and shut his eyes. The house rocked. Broken glass tinkled. The master was everywhere. Thomas had collected a bush on his travels. He peered into the room through its leaves. He couldn't speak. The station master was furious. His wife picked up her place. Miserable engine, she scolded. Just look what you've done to our breakfast. Now I shall have to cook some more. Back to the wall. Master fell. This time, it fell on Thomas. Thomas felt depressed. Workmen propped up the house with strong poles and laid rails through the garden. Meanwhile, Donald and Douglas arrived. Yourself, Thomas. We'll soon have you back on the rails, they laughed. Donald and Douglas, puffing hard, managed to haul Thomas back to safety. Bits of fencing, the bush, and a broken window frame festooned his front, which was badly twisted. The twins laughed and left him. Thomas was in disgrace. There was worse to come. You are a very naughty engine.
I know, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Thomas's voice was muffled behind his bush. You must go to the works and have your front mended. It will be a long job.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, a diesel rail car will do your work.
A diesel, sir?
Thomas spluttered. Yes, Thomas. Diesels always stay in their sheds till they are wanted. Diesels never gallivant off to breakfast in station masters' houses.